Record, yeah, you want to?
Yes.
So, health definition according to the WHO is it a state of physical, mental, social, and spiritual well-being and absence of a disease. If you see, health in yoga is seen to be state of balance, samatvam, in which you have this samatvam, physical, mental, emotional, and spiritual aspects of a person. It's not merely absence of a disease, but also the harmony of body, mind, and soul. Okay. So if you see, what is this mental, physical, spiritual, and emotional? If you see our Ashtanga yoga, you can correlate like asanas, pranayama is for physical. Okay. Then comes yama niyamas. Then comes pratyahara and dharana. And for the spiritual, dhyana and samadhi. So all this will cover in the Ashtanga yoga. So that is the path we have to follow. And what is a disease? An imbalance in a body energies. What are that? Doshas. In Ayurveda, or the mental disturbances, that is Adi and Vyadi. Yoga defines a disease as outcome of the mental imbalance. What is that? The first one, Adi, then it manifests in the physical body as a Vyadi. I think we have also gone through it. So nothing to the next slide. So this is a definition what we have seen, a state of complete physical, mental, social, and spiritual well-being, and not merely absence of a disease or infirmity. This definition goes beyond the absence of illness, emphasizing a holistic approach that includes physical well-being, mental well-being, and social well-being. What is physical well-being? The proper functioning of the body without any illness or impairment. Like, see, basically, you can say, suppose you are getting early in the morning, and today you feel like I'm enthusiastic to do the work, then you can consider you are healthy. And if you get up and you think today, okay, I have to do this work, I have to do that work, if you are not so enthusiastic, then you can say there is something wrong. That is a basic parameter you can check yourself. Mental well-being. What is mental well-being? A state of mental state where a person can manage stress, work productivity. One second. Work productivity and contribute to their community. Social, the ability to interact positively with society, having supportive relationships and contributing to the society. If you see, this socializing is very important. Olden days, whatever the fest, we can say the festivals or some like carnivals would happen in some villages. They call it as jatra in Hindi. I don't know what they call. So these are nothing but these are socializing things. Or you see, every day evening people used to meet under one huge purple tree. When there will be one seating, one person will sit. Everyone will come. They will discuss. So this is how they used to socialize. This is also very important. Next. Swast, you also learned this. What is that? Samadosha, Samagni, Samadhatu, Malakriya, Prasanna Atma Indriya Manah Swasthiti Viyate. What is that? All these doshas should be equal. And how many? Three. Vata, Pitta, Kapha. And Samagni cha, there are 13 Agnis in the body. That's 13 Agnis should be balanced. Samadhatu, there are seven Dhatus. What are that? Rasa, Raktha, Mamsa, Medha, Maja, Hasti, Maja, and Shukra.
Write it
And
down. Write it down, Parul. Why my questions? This is Ayurveda. Write it down again.
Rasa, Rakta.
Let them write.
So this is the order of the
Yeah.
components which will form from the food. Rasa, juice, rakta, blood, mamsa, muscle.
Flesh, flesh.
मैदा, फैट, हस्ती, बोन्स, मज्जा, बोन मैरो, शुक्रा, द वाइटल एनर्जी इन मेल इट इज स्पर्म, इन फीमेल इट इज एग, ओवम. This Shukra will become convert into Tejas and Ojas. So if you see this conversion, so at least today you are eating some food. It takes for minimum 40 days to convert it into bones. So remember, whatever food you are taking, don't think that by tomorrow it will eliminate. So to convert from rasa to rakta, rakta to mamsa, so all this process, each step by step, it takes a particular time. So you have to be careful what food you are taking today. In Ayurveda, the ancient Indian system of medicine, the concept of health refers to the swasth. It described more holistically, incorporating the spiritual well-being along with the physical, mental and social dimensions. The classical Ayurvedic definition of health can be found in the Sushruta Samhita, which states, what is that? Samado chasama agni chasama dhatu malak kriya prasanna atma indriya manaha swasthiti bijate. Not only this.
This is Ayurveda, they will ask. Second matter is just repeat our three doshas. Just highlight on three doshas.
Okay.
My
Prasanna,
questions.
yeah, prasanna atma means the soul, indriyas, and manas should be at peace. Okay, then what are this samadosha? We have three doshas, vat, pitta, and kapha. Vat is nothing but it's a combination of air and space. Pitta is a combination of fire and water. Kapha, it's a combination of water and earth. So generally, each one has some qualities. They also say kapham pangum pittam pangum pangum mala dhatuvah. This also from Ayurveda text means without vata, kapha and pitta are handicapped. So vata will take this pitta and kapha, the movement. In simple, vata is nothing but the movement. Any kind of movement in the body. Pitta means heat. Functionality, you can say. Kapha means mucus. It is stability or the lethargy. So Vata people, how they will be? They will be always disturbed. Air can be stayed in one place. It will move here and there. So mind also will be very chanchalta. So they will move here and there, physically and mentally. Pitta people, heat body. They always be like they have something sitting on something hot on. Kapha people are very lazy. You see, if you tell them to get up, they'll get up after 3 hours. That is also very lethargical. If you tell them to bring something, they'll be very lazy. And as per the Ayurveda, up to 14 years, it is considered to be as kapha. From the 14 to 60 years, you will be dominated by pitta. And after 60 years, you will be dominated by vata. If you see, that's why up to 14 years, generally, children will have this all cold, cough, breathing issues. But once they cross 14 years, they'll not have anything. And that is the time, if you see from the age of 14, if you see little back, not today's. If today, you cannot say any age, anything may happen. But 14 to 60, people will be very fit. Because pitta is dominating. Once that fire is reduced, vata means known for the body pains. So after 60 olden days, 60 or 70 people used to get joint pains. This is how Vata, Pitta, Kapha will dominate. And it is known by the Nadi Pariksha. So that is called as the pulse diagnose. Okay, so next. See, here we have mentioned a little about this. Already you know it. The three doshas, vata, pitta, kapha, are should be in balance. Then the digestive fire is called as jataragni. It is called the functional, its function should be proper. And there are five panchabhuta agnis and seven saptadhatu agnis. Total, it becomes 13 agnis as per the Ayurveda. Then the body tissues, dhatus, it should be in harmony. Like what I said, rasa, rakta, mamsa, medha, asti, maja, shukra. Then the malakriya. There are three types of malakriya. Mala, mutra, swedya. Means urine, faces, stools, and sweat. These three should be proper. See, two things you have to be. One is nourishment, one is elimination. So, if these two things you can balance, then you will be healthy. There is a contentment of clarity in the soul, Atma, Indriya, sense, and the Manaha, mind. Then, Swasthiti Bijate, then you are said to be swast or healthy. Next one. Ayurvedic health thus emphasizes balance across these elements, reflecting the true well-being involved not just the body but also mind, sense, and spirit. See, already we have covered all these topics. So just it's a revision as per the syllabus. Next. Already we have also seen the Adi and Vyadi. I think I have explained to you very clearly. Okay. Just see, Adi is a mental or emotional conflict which is considered the root cause of all the physical diseases according to the Yoga Vasistha. Mental disturbances like stress, anxiety, fear, anger, and other negative emotions disturb the mind, leading to the mental imbalances. This mental turmoil is described as a precursor to the physical alignment ailments. The mind, when clouded by the emotional distress, loses its clarity and balance. This imbalance disturbs the flow of prana and the functioning of the body system. In other words, Adi is the mental disturbance or the internal stress that lays foundation to the disease. If you see what happens, I said there is a seed formed in the Manomaya Kosha known as the Adi. Then it affects your prana. What is that prana? It's a digestion. It leads to three conditions, that is Ajiti, Adijiti, and Kunjaljiti. Then again, further it goes to the physical body and disturbs one of the organ. This is how the Adi in the Manomaya Kosha results in the Vyadi in the Annamaya Kosha. The next. Apatrayas. What are these? I think I also told about this. When it will come? In which context I told this? Adibhautika, Daivika, and Atyatmika. Can anyone?
Harold, Goro.
One in we did it two times. We did this. We even read about this in Yoga Vasishta also when sir you were teaching us. It was
Okay.
before one of the chapters before the Yoga Vasishta. It was
Yes.
mentioned.
Did I
I
told
don't
you this?
remember. Yes, sir. We remember this.
Okay. You tell me what is the starting prayer, anyone?
Starting off, Adhyatmik means
No, tell me the starting prayer, anyone?
anything that is within us which causes disturbance.
Yeah, that's
Then we
okay.
have Adi Bhautik. Bhautik means outside. Huh? And
That
Adhyatmik is
is fine.
whatever is there with the divinity.
Yes,
So
good.
are you asking a Patanjali prayer?
Any prayer, what is your starting prayer? Just tell me one, anyone.
Yogena chittasya. पतंजलि का नचित्तस्य पदेन वाचा मलम शरीरस्य वेद्यकेन अच्छा योगा
लोपा
करोतम प्रवरम प्रवरम मुनीनम पतंजलिम पांजलि ध्यान है तो
मी
उसमें
देन एनी शांति मंत्र फॉर मी एनी वन, वॉट इज एनी
क्या,
शांति मंत्र कैन यू
सर्वे
से?
भवन्तु सुखिनः, सर्वे भक्तं तु निरामया, सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु, मा कश्चित् दुःख भा भवेत्। ओम शांति शांति शांति। इन दिस कॉन्टेक्स्ट वी हैड फर्स्ट डिस्कस्ड इट, ओम शांति थ्री
यस
टाइम्स, थ्राइस व्हेन वी
यस
चैंट शांति।
एवरी टाइम वॉट एवर वी चैंट इन द एंड वी से शांति शांति शांति, मीन्स ओम पीस पीस पीस. वाई वी आर डू मेंशनिंग ओनली थ्री शांतिस, वाई नॉट फाइव, वाई नॉट टू? बिकॉज दैट थ्री आर रिलेटेड टू दिस थ्री, आदि भौतिक, आदि दैविक एंड आध्यात्मिक. मीन्स इन द वर्ल्ड दे आर थ्री काइंड ऑफ सफरिंग्स. वन इज भौतिक, मीन्स विद द फिजिकल बींग्स, इट माइट बी अ ह्यूमन, इट माइट बी अ एनिमल, इट माइट बी एनी फिजिकल बींग. नेक्स्ट वन विद दैविक, मीन्स नेचुरल कैलामिटीज, नेचुरल कैलामिटीज लाइक यू कैन से अर्थक्वेक्स और एनी अदर थिंग. ओके, आध्यात्मिक मीन्स इट हैज टू, एट फिजिकल लेवल इट्स अ इम्बैलेंस ऑफ वात पित्त कफ, एंड एट मेंटल लेवल इट माइट बी काम क्रोध लोभ मोह मद आश्चर्य, जेलस एंगर एंगर वॉट एवर इट इज. वाई वी आर सेइंग थ्री शांतिस मीन्स वी आर नॉट ओनली प्रेइंग फॉर अस, वी आर ऑल्सो प्रेइंग फॉर द यूनिवर्सल वेल बीइंग, दैट ऑल द पीपल इन द वर्ल्ड हैज टू गेट पीस फ्रॉम दिस थ्री काइंड ऑफ सफरिंग्स. दिस इज द रीजन वाई वी डू वी चैंट शांति मंत्र इन द बिफोर एंड एंडिंग फॉर द यूनिवर्सल वेल बीइंग. सो सी द ब्यूटी ऑफ अवर ट्रेडिशन, बाई डूइंग योगा वी आर गेटिंग बेनिफिटेड, एंड बाई चैंटिंग दिस शांति मंत्र वी आर ऑल्सो प्रेइंग फॉर द यूनिवर्सल वेल बीइंग. That's why it's very important. The next. Kleshas, avidya, asmita, raga, dvesha, apnivesha, this also we done. Avidya, kshetram, uttaresam, prasuptatan, vichinno, udharanam. Means avidya is a
Patan
root cause.
release.
Patan. Avidya is a root cause for all the other one, asmita, raga, dvesha, apnivesha. Avidya means false knowledge. With the false knowledge, what we'll do, we create identity, that is asmita. Then whichever we like, we get attracted to it, that is raga. And whichever we don't like, we develop dvesha. Whether it's right or wrong is secondary. We like, so we attach. We don't like, we detach. Apnivesha means fear of losing. It might be a fear of death, it might be anything. Why? For this all, avidya is uttaresa, means that is the field, that is the root. This also we have seen. The next. This is also Patanjali. What is it? Vyadhisthana, samshaya, pramada, alasya, virati, bhranti, darshana, alabdha, bhumikatva, anavasthitattvani, chitta, vikshepaha, te, antarayaha. What is addition? Dukkha, tormanasya, angame, jayatva, swasa, prasvasa,
Come on, come on. It should come
Vikshepaha
from your mouth.
savabhuha.
It
We
should come
have to
from
be
your mouth.
fast.
Divya, bolo bolo. Study nahi kiya hai.
So this 9-1, I know the dukkha door dormanasya, I forgot that.
This
This
is the symptoms of that. Okay, sir, change the slide. Meenan sir, please go for the previous slide. Previous slide.
one. Yes.
No, no, tell Devya. Tell the sutra.
अविद्या अस्मिता राग द्वेषा
No, no, no.
अभिनिवेश द्वेषा
That okay. The next one, the Vyadhisthana, Chitta Vikshepa.
प्रसादम चित्त प्रसादम
No, चित्त
Sir, go.
विक्षेपा इज अंतरायास।
Vikshepas.
सॉरी
See the sutra and tell.
व्याधि स्यान संशय प्रमाण
Prabhada.
प्रमाद
प्रमादा
प्रमादा अच्छा ओ सॉरी सॉरी
आलस्य
कर्मा प्रमाण
प्रमाण
अविरति
इज डिफरेंट एंड प्रमादा इज डिफरेंट.
प्रमाद करेक्ट
प्रमादा प्रमादा आलस्य.
अभी आलस्य अविरति भ्रांति दर्शन इट्स अ बिग वर्ड आई फॉरगॉट लास्ट टू इज आई एम नॉट एबल टू रिकॉलेक्ट
ओके ठीक है. अलब्ध भूमिकत्व अनुवस्थितत्व. सी अकॉर्डिंग टू पतंजलि दे आर नाइन ऑब्स्टेकल्स. व्हाट आर दैट प्रिवेंट अ योगी टू रीच द गोल. फर्स्ट वन इज व्याधि. व्याधि मीन्स फिजिकल और मेंटल इलनेस दैट क्रिएट्स इम्बैलेंस एंड डिस्टर्बेंस मेकिंग इट डिफिकल्ट टू मेंटेन द डिसिप्लिन रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द फिजिकल प्रैक्टिस. दैट इज अ पर्सन सफरिंग फ्रॉम क्रॉनिक क्रॉनिक पेन मे फाइंड इट हार्ड टू सिट एंड मेडिटेट एंड फोकस ऑन द ब्रेथ वर्क. ओके सपोज यू गॉट फीवर विल यू बी रेडी टू डू योगा. स्पेशली दिस वायरल फीवर इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट. नेक्स्ट स्थाना मीन्स लेजीनेस और एपथी लैक ऑफ मोटिवेशन और एंथुजियाज्म टू एंगेज इन प्रैक्टिस. इट कैन मैनिफेस्ट एज प्रोक्रास्टिनेशन और द लेथार्जी. सर नेक्स्ट मीनन सर.
हाँ
व्याधि स्थान संशया मीन्स डाउट. दिस इज द बिगेस्ट वन. वॉट इज दैट कैन आई डू इट. सो दैट इज द बिगेस्ट वन. डाउट अबाउट द टीचिंग वंस ओन एबिलिटी. लाइक एवरीबडी हैज दिस अनुमान कॉम्प्लेक्स. तो अगेन समबडी हैज टू पुश देम फ्रॉम बैक साइड. यू हैव टू डू दैट हनुमान चालीसा ज्ञान गुण सागर. और यू हैव टू चैंट हिज ग्रेटनेस. तो वी ऑल्सो पुश यू विथ ऑल योर क्रेडिबिलिटीज एंड टैलेंट देन ओनली विल गेट रिड ऑफ दिस संशय. मीन्स इट्स डाउट अबाउट द टीचिंग्स वन एबिलिटी वन ओन्स एबिलिटी और द प्रोसेस ऑफ योगा. इट माइट बी एनीथिंग. यू मे डाउट द टीचर. यू मे डाउट इन योर ओन एबिलिटी और यू मे डाउट द इवन द प्रोसेस. दिस कैन लेड टू लैक ऑफ ट्रस्ट इन द पाथ एंड कन्फ्यूजन कैन क्रिएट इंटरनल कॉन्फ्लिक्ट. Doubting whether meditation is really effective, leading to the inconsistent practice. So this is what happens in samshaya. Pramada, careless or negligence. If somebody, what we do, they drive zigzag on the road with 100, 120 speed, what we say is negligent, is careless. That is called as pramada. Because when you are careless, then only the incident happens. Neglect the practice due to carelessness, distraction, or overconfident when one becomes casual or inattentive, progress halts. Skipping essential practice like pranayama or meditation, thinking that they are not necessary. So, this is what happens, pramada. So, all these are obstacles in the path of yoga. Like you can see sadhaka tattvas and badhaka tattvas in Hatha Yoga. Got it? The same, what are these? These are obstacles means which tattvas? Understood? Badhaka tattvas. Next. Alasya, laziness or dullness. Laziness is both body and mind. Unlike sthana, which is mental lack of enthusiasm, alasya reflects the physical lethargy. Lack of physical energy to perform asanas or practical consistency. See, if you are physically lethargy, then mentally also you'll be lethargy. Because mentally, who is stable, this physical body, they can push their body. Avirati, sensory distractions, attachment to the sensory pleasures and inability to detach from the worldly desires, this prevent one to focusing on the spiritual growth. Like constant distraction on the materialistic object, social media or seeking sensory gratification instead of focusing on the spiritual practice. What? Okay, now you have to get up and you have to do yoga at morning 5 o'clock. But what you do? Some people will prefer to sleep. So they are preferring pleasure rather than doing yoga. So what they are doing? Instead of getting that permanent, if you do yoga, it will help lifelong. But if you sleep, it will be happy for 1 hour, 2 hours. So this is a distraction. Or what? You have a class, but you have nice film. You'll watch film or watch reels in the Instagram. So you are attached to it, the sensory attachment. You have to realize which is important to you. So next.
Getting up at Brahma Muhurtam will give additional benefit of meditation, will lead to meditation. Practicing
Yes.
meditation during Brahma Muhurtam, that is at 2 and a half hours before the sunrise, will lead to a
right.
active reduction in the breathing level, thereby increasing the concentration level. Please remember that when your breathing level goes on decreasing, the concentration level goes on increasing. It leads toward the dhyana. Concentration is increasing means you are leading towards dharana. When the dharana becomes focused on the object, it becomes dhyana. And when dhyana gets absorbed in that, it leads to the samadhi state of different stages of samadhi. Sampraja samadhi, asampraja samadhi, sampraja samadhi, and ultimately is nirbija samadhi. Okay? Abhinav, correct me. You are the author in Patanjali Baba.
No, sir. Yeah. The next, sir.
Next. Branti
Bhranti Darshana means delusions or illusions. Misunderstanding the path and having wrong ideas about the nature of reality, this can lead to the following an incorrect path or the belief system. Misinterpreting spiritual experience or being misled by false teachings that derive from the truth path of yoga, deviated from the truth path. You see, Bhranti Darshana means it's an illusion. You'll think one instead of the other. What is this? Where you can relate to this Bhranti Darshana?
In Chitta Vrittis also, we had that illusion.
Which one?
Klishta, Klishta, when we had Pramada. I'll have to refer to this now. There are so many things I've done today.
So are you asking example of a spiritual
Bilkul.
experience? Like how they've written
Yeah.
on all
No, it
the
might be anything. Bhranti
names
Darshana might be
of
anything. It's a false perception. Where you have that false knowledge will come with avidya. Again, avidya is closely related to viparyayo mithya jnanam matadupa system. Okay, you have to correlate. Everything is correlated. This is sutra, thread. One and one, there is an interlink. Nothing separate. You have to interlink. Next, alabdha bhumikatva means inability to progress. Even after dedicating practice, the practitioner may feel stuck and unable to make the progress, which led to the frustration and doubt. Despite of years of meditation, one might feel they are not reaching the deeper levels of awareness or peace or causing frustration. See, alabdha bhumikatva means, suppose from Maharashtra, you want to travel to Delhi. In Delhi, you want to go to Chandni Chowk or anything. What happened? You went to Delhi, but you are unable to go to Chandni Chowk. So inability to reach the final destination or whatever they called as samadhi. That is called alabdha bhumikatva. Anavasti tattvani means once you have reached, but you don't have stability. Next, again you came back. Next time you are unable to reach. So you have reached Delhi once, but you are unable to reach the destination. That is alabdha bhumikatva. But you reach at the destination once, but second time you are not stable there and you are not able to reach. Second time, that is anavasti tattvani. The next one. Instability. What I said, even after achieving a certain level of success in practice, there is a possibility of falling back and losing the progress made. A yogi who developed a deep meditation might lost focus due to the distractions of worldly temptations and regress to the earlier stage of practice. Once he has reached the samadhi state and he has fallen down, but second time he is unable to reach. See, once you know the path, you have to reach, but it is very difficult. So once you reach, you have to be stable there. So these are all the obstacles of a yogi. So next. Dukkha daurmanasya angame jayatva swasa prasvasa vichcheta savabuha means what? This you have. This is additional bonus. Like what happens if you go to a shop, if you take some 5,000 or 10,000 sale, then what? They'll use some gift coupon. Right? Extra. So similarly, this is also like extra. Or also called as symptoms. The nine antarayas are not just obstacles in themselves, but also create disturbances or distractions and mental distractions and mental disturbances. We can call them symptoms or like extra additional thing. These obstacles led to a specific mental and emotional thing that is dukkha. Dukkha means the frustration or pain caused by the obstacles. It means suffering. We say is very dukkha. Daurmanasya means depression. You can see this kind of people you can see everywhere now. You see anyone, they are always sad. Daurmanasya, the
Don't one minute,
emotional.
don't mistake dukkha for sadness. Here dukkha is not sadness, is a different
Suffering.
meaning.
Dukkha means suffering, not sadness.
Divya and
What
Parvati,
suffering?
no.
Answer. Again, you have three kinds of sufferings. It might be any. Next, Daurmanasya means the depression of the emotional state. Angame Jayatva means the physical uneasy, what you call when your body will shiver. That is Angame Jayatva, trembling of the body, restlessness. The fourth one, Swasa Praswasa, irregularities in the breath pattern. That is called, that are the four. What is that? Dukkha Daurmanasya, Angame Jayatva, Swasa Praswasa, Vikshepaha, Sahabhuvaha. These are like additional things to that nine obstacles. So next.
Yeah.
Shuddhi Kriyas. Dhautirbhasti tada neti tadakam naulikam tata kapala vatishyani shetkarmani prasishyate.
Very, 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 very important for Vaiva. Separate
Agar this,
question
agar
on
you see,
Siddhikriyas.
so you have
Both
to go with
on
Grand
Garuda
Master
Samhita as well as Hatava Pradipika.
Pratipika.
Garuda Samhita,
Yes,
six types of Dhauti. Please remember.
they are called as Shat Kriyas or Shuddhi Prakriya or the cleansing techniques. First one is Neti, nasal cleansing, removes the excess mucus and congestion, improving the respiratory health. First, my question is, who has to do this Shuddhi Kriya? Everyone has to do.
As per Hatha Yoga Pradipika, only if somebody has got fat or excess mucus, medha or mucus, in that case only they are meant to do Shuddhi Kriya, Vishata Kriya.
Okay, somebody has excess volume.
No, sorry, for Gheranda. Sorry, as per Gheranda, if I'm
Okay,
not,
what?
nahi, Hatha Yoga only.
You don't get
It is
confused. You just. Okay, if somebody has excess vata.
Vata, it's not required to do this Kata Kriya because they'll start losing more weight. That depends on the Ayurvedic practitioner if they recommend some kind of.
No. Generally, why we do this is if there is any balance in tridoshas, then only we recommend Shat Kriyas. If the person is already balanced, then there is no need for Shat Kriyas. He can directly start with asanas. Clear? So Jay mentioned in the book Medha and what the same one, the fat and mucus, then they have to do, but
Mucus.
in the general practice, it is for to balance the tridoshas. See, if you are doing Vamana Dhauti, what is happening there? You are removing the excess vata only, no air. Shankh Prakshalana, what you are doing, you are cleansing the GI tract. If you see, most of the cleansing practices are in the mouth to anus. So that is the importance of the digestive tract. First one, Neti, nasal cleansing. What happens with the nasal cleansing? Which. What is that? Shakti will come. Which Siddhi will come for you? Mastery over which one? Kechari Mudra. You'll get that Kechari Siddhi. Trataka, you'll get Shambhavi. This is.
Next, what happened, Avinash?
I think unka connection has gone. एग्जाम में क्या बोलेंगे सर? हठ योग प्रदीपिका में वेरी क्लियरली देव सेड, इफ ओनली देयर इज एक्सेस ऑफ फैट और फ्लेम इन द बॉडी देन ओनली द शतक्रिया शुड बी परफॉर्म्ड, अदरवाइज बट अदर्स नॉट सफरिंग फ्रॉम एक्सेस ऑफ दी शुड नॉट परफॉर्म इट.
In auto certificate is not required, no? Anybody can do it, no?
हाँ सो व्हाट, हाँ तो बात वो क्लियरली, तो वाइवा में अगर ऐसा पूछे तो व्हाट विल बी गिव द आंसर बिकॉज.
It is mandatory in case of Garuda Samhita. It is not mandatory in case of this one. Then you specify it is mandatory, then
In
who should do a compulsory do it. Then you mention the as mentioned now. Next, Abhinav.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. Dauti means it's a digestive cleansing, means Dauti means to wash. Cleaning the stomach and digestive tract. Basti means colon cleansing, cleaning the large intestine. Okay. Next, Nauli means abdominal cleansing. Actually, there is only Nauli Chalana as per the text. But in their explanation, they have mentioned about Vamana, Daksha, then the rotation, Nauli Chalana. Kapalabhati. Kapal means skull, Bhati means pages. It is the shining of the skull, but not what we do the abdomen. That is Kapalabhati as pranayam. This is Kapalabhati as Kriya. In this, what you have? Vatsara, Yutsara, and sorry, what krama, youth krama, and one more thing is sheet krama means one is first one is like inhale to the left, exhale through right, very forcefully. That is what krama. So youth means you have to take water to the nostrils and take it out from the mouth. Sheet means you take water from the mouth
opposite.
And you'll from the nostrils you'll take it out. Trataka, Trataka Petikam, the jewel box, they call it as. It is eye cleansing, and you will practice more of Trataka, you will get Shambhavi Siddhi. Clear up to here? Next one. You have is Trigunas, Panchakoshas, Panchapranas. What are the three gunas? Tattva, Rajas, and Tamas. What is Sattva Guna? Where you get these gunas? These gunas are related to Chitta Bhumis. Shukta, Muda, Vishukta, Ekagra, Niruddha. I have told you when we are seeing about Chitta Bhumis. Sattva means purity, balance, and knowledge. Rajas means activity, change, or the energy. Tamas means inertia, ignorance, lethargy. And if you see from these three gunas, Panchabhuta system, from the Panchabhutas, three doshas. And these three gunas are present in Prakruti. If you go to again Sankhya philosophy, Sankhya Darshanam, there you have Purusha and Prakruti. In Prakruti, you have all these three gunas. If you are beyond these gunas, if you go to Gunatita state, then you will become Purusha. So this is as per the Sankhya philosophy. Then Panchakoshas, I think I have explained you very clearly. What is that? Annamaya, Pranamaya, Manomaya, Vijnanamaya, Anandamaya. What happens and how this Adi and Vyadi. So this I have explained you very clearly. Next one is Panchapranas. Prana, Apana. Vyana Udana Samana. Hruday Prano Buday Apana Samana Navi Mandale Udana Kantadeshastu Vyana Sarva Shari Rakaha. This also I explained you clearly last time. So prana is in the lungs, its main function is to govern the respiratory system. It moves upwards. Apana is in the excretory. It moves downwards. It looks after the excretory system. Uday Pano, Uday Apana, Samana Nabi Mandale, Samana is in the navel region and it is towards the center. Udana Kantadeshastu, it is generally governs the throat and it is moves upwards. Dhyana Sarva Shari Ragaha means throughout the body. It is a circulatory system. From the center, it moves to throughout the body.
See all the command in the subject. Arul, Divya, see all the command in the subject. Next.
One second. Got the current on in the
Anjaposha.
laptop. Next one, after this, you have chakras.
Recording in
नहीं है,
progress.
वन मिनट चक्रास बाद में
ओके सर, पंचकोशस एंड पंच प्राणास.
पंचकोश इज ओवर.
यस यस, पंचकोशस पंच प्राणास ओवर.
अपन लोकेशन लोकेशन दिस यू एक्सप्लेन
यस
लोकेशन
यस, ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन, नाउ ऑल्सो एक्सप्लेन.
समान यू हैव टू एक्सप्लेन. हाँ यू आर टॉक यू आर टॉक ऑन पंचकोश एवरीथिंग यू हैव टू एक्सप्लेन नॉट ओनली दिस फाइव वर्ड्स यू हैव टू एक्सप्लेन वन बाय वन. अरुण वाई माय क्वेश्चन पंचकोश यू आर टॉक ऑन पंचकोश सो यू यू आर टॉक नॉट ओनली दिस फाइव वर्ड्स ओके.
Sir, I have sent you the screen share request. Can you accept it? I'll share them a photo of the chakras.
या उदाहरण एडवांस इज हो मैनेज हो
Screen sharing. Screen sharing. Allow the screen sharing.
शर चक्रस.
Meenan sir,
हाँ
allow the screen sharing.
शर चक्रस जी आई प्रिपेयर्ड इट जस्ट एक्सप्लेन नो
No, I'll explain after this. There is a table. It will be much helpful for them.
ओके व्हाट
Okay.
इज गोइंग ऑन ना दैट्स व्हाई बोलो.
Yeah.
हाँ
Now,
प्रिपेयर कर.
what is it? Chakras. Okay. This set chakras are nothing but there are some energy centers. If you see, it starts from Muladhara, Swadhisthana, Manipura, Anahata, Vishuddhi, Ajna or Ajna, what they call it as, and Sahasrara. And the physical coordinates are, you have a gland to associate with each chakra. And Muladhara is a, called it as base chakra. And it has a syllable, what you call it as the base sound. You have a base sound to it, and there is a musical note also to it. If you see, the bass sound is lam and the musical note is sa. Similarly, there is Swadhisthana, and this is related to the Prithvi Tattva, and it is at the base of the spine. Next, Swadhisthana is related to the Jala Tattva. And if you see the basic chakra, if you go deep, it's very deep. Chakra is disturbed, what happens? That is very, very deep. Initially, we will see at the superficial layer. It is basically for the trust. And if you see, Swadhisthana is consist of tribulus, like tribular, it is tribulus chakra. What is that? Swadhisthana, spirituality and sexuality. And it is related to the creativity. It's the basic Bija mantra is Vam. The sound is, the musical note sound is Re. The third one is Manipura, the solar flex. Or the energy chakra, the wisdom power, because from the navel region only we'll get the energy because of food digests there. And okay, each one has different petals, that also we'll see. And the sound is Ram and Ga. Anahata, the heart chakra, like Lord Krishna has activated the Anahata chakra, so he shows a lot of love and compassion. The sound is Yam and Ma. Next, Vishuddhi is a throat chakra where you have thyroid gland. It's related to the communication. That's why if you see people with thyroid, they struggle in communication. Hum, pa is a sound. Next one is Ajna or Ajna chakra. Third eye we call it as It is all about awareness. The sound is Om. Da is a musical note. If you see, each one has a petal. Petal means the rotor, there is a lotus. From the lotus, you have that petals. In each petal, there is a sound. The base Muladhara has four. Swadhisthana has six petals. Manipura has 10. Anahata has 12. Vishuddhi has 16. And Ajna has 2. Okay. Sahasrara has 1000. There is colors.
Color
Should I go with this?
and Bija Mantra.
First one is red. Bija Mantra I told. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, dark blue, and purple. See, colors, why I'm not telling, each book has given different colors. So you
See,
better.
if you are not able to remember, the Bija color, Bija.
Vibhjar, and you go with as per the book, what colors you have.
Violet, indigo, blue, green, okay. Orange, red.
Okay.
Why your question, please? Varun, Divya, why your question? Recite about chakras, give its importance, and what are the benefits, Bija Mantra and all. Okay. Which are the glands related to it? Everything you have to talk. Everything. Okay.
Why chakras are more important in our yogic practice? If you see, each chakra is correlated with one musical sound. What is that? Sa, ri, ga, ma, pa, da, sa. So if you see, when chakras are inline, means chakras are properly functioning or chakras are balanced. If you see, then all these sounds will be in a rhythm. So that condition is called as rhythm of the life. When chakras are balanced, your rhythm of the life is balanced. When chakras are imbalanced, that rhythm will be disturbed. Are you ready to listen any song without the rhythm? How it will be? So similarly, if this rhythm is disturbed, then our health is also disturbed. So chakras are nothing but they are called as the rhythm of the life. So this is about chakras. So next. Next, Meenan sir.
Shall I go to next?
Yes.
Holistic health.
Holistic health. What is holistic? It means complete. Holistic health in yoga addresses the four dimensions of health. What is that? Physical, mental, social, and spiritual. Physical achieves through asanas and cleansing techniques. Mental achieves through pranayama, meditation, and mindfulness. Social, yama niyamas. Spiritual, you have dhyana and samadhi.
Yeah.
A person with digestive issues may follow yoga's holistic approach. Asanas, this is for example, asanas you can do any Pavan Mukta asana, Vajrasana. For the mindfulness, avoiding overeating, adapting sattvic diet, pure and balanced food for long-term health. This is how the holistic approach will be. There is asanas, there is mindfulness, there is diet, there are many other things which comes. So this is example for the holistic health. Any doubts?
Shall I stop the recording?
Yes, sir.